Yeah. Can we just go back to the simple kind of living? Can we just go back and maybe start from the beginning? Back to better days when love was for the giving. Can we just go back to the way we were?
Welcome back to Generations. Merry Christmas, everybody. Merry Christmas. I'm so excited because today I have all of my family with me. Well, almost all of my family. I'm missing my son-in-law. I have my daughter, Ashley.
Yes.
I have my son, Alvin. And I have my wonderful husband of 37 years. Right. Alvin.
Wow.
Love.
Merry Christmas.
So welcome, fam. How y'all doing?
Good.
Thanks for joining us, guys.
Generations.
All right. We are part of the show.
Yeah, you're part of the show this time.
Generations, Alvin.
Yes. It's Christmas time.
Yes.
And so, Ashley, I want you to just tell us, what does Christmas mean to you?
Well, I think it really is the most wonderful time of the year for many reasons. But, of course, it means remembering Christ, remembering the gift of his life and him becoming a human being and taking on flesh and being able to sympathize with what we go through in life. So I'm just thankful for the gift of Jesus, his life, of course, the gift of salvation because of him. Yeah. And that we get to kind of mimic the giving spirit of giving gifts and spending time together. So, I don't know. Christmas is just awesome to me.
Cool,
I love it.
Cool. What is the real meaning of Christmas, Alvin? And tell me why it's important for people to know the real meaning of Christmas.
All right. Well, I think the real meaning of Christmas is Christ. Mm-hmm. His birth, that's why we celebrate it. That's not why everybody celebrates it, but that's why we celebrate it. Jesus being born, like Ashley said, it was a very sacrificial, generous offer for God to come in this way and to serve humanity. Mm. So I do think, Christ, I mean, it's in the name, Christmas. You can't say Christmas without Christ.
Yeah.
So I do think he's the reason. And the reason why I think everybody should know that is because it's the good news. It's the good news of salvation. It's the good news of hope. And everyone needs that.
Yeah.
No matter who you are, everybody needs the good news of Jesus. So I do think it's important for everybody to know.
And I think even though this is a time where most people are celebrating and are excited and happy, we have a lot of people who are not excited about it because they're dealing with a lot of hurt and a lot of pain or being lonely, whatever the situation is. A lot of people have lost loved ones.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so I think it's always important to know the reason for the season, but I think it's more important even now, you know, seeing with what our world is going through and all the pain and the agony of Jesus. People need to know about Jesus.
Yeah.
The love of Jesus, you know.
Sure.
I like to share a scripture every time we come on. And today I'm just going to share Luke 2:11. It says, "For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." He is the Savior. Mm-hmm. What do you have to say about that?
You know, some people say, just a song says, Emmanuel.
Yeah,
And Christmas reminds us that God is with us.
Yeah.
Because he came, he said, I'm never going to leave you.
Yeah.
You know, even when he was resurrected, he said, you know, I'm with you always.
Right.
And so at Christmas, it's a time for us to actually say, reflect on what Christ has done, but also to remember that he's with us.
That's good.
You know.
Amen.
And so I think that's really important for us to remember.
Yeah, because a lot of times we focus in on him being born today.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But I know when you teach sometime, you talk about how Jesus came for us. He lived for us. He died for us. Mm-hmm. He was resurrected for us, went to heaven for us.
He's coming back for us.
All for us.
You know, so all of that is wrapped up in Christmas.
Yes.
And like you said, the promise of him never leaving us alone.
Mm-hmm.
So even if you're at home and it appears that you're by yourself, you're not.
Yeah.
Because Jesus was born and he promised never to leave you or forsake you. So I think everybody has a reason to celebrate.
Yeah,
just
absolutely.
Because of that, right?
Yeah.
The real meaning of Christmas should encourage everybody to celebrate. Okay, family is important. You know, now when I grew up, you guys grew up different than me. When I was growing up, we didn't celebrate tree. Christmas with a tree or
presents.
Oh no, definitely no presents, really. when you think about it, my mom and dad had ten siblings, but they didn't believe in that. They were so focused on the real meaning of Christmas. And so it was always about family, singing, gathering around a piano. We always had Christmas dinner, you know, eating. But it wasn't focused on the commercial part of Christmas.
Yeah.
But, you know, when we came together, your dad wanted to make sure you guys experienced the Christmas that he had.
Thank you, Dad.
Thanks,
Dad. We appreciate your secular Christmas.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
It's all about balance.
Yes, Ashley, balance, yeah.
A little balance.
Oh, yeah. I got a question, Ashley. I never thought about this.
What? So he's the one
because you guys didn't celebrate traditional Christmas.
Right.
Did y'all receive gifts from people?
No, not really.
No, I mean, not within
the family.
I remember one day
my brother Daniel, Uncle Daniel, was determined we were going to celebrate Christmas.
Right.
So he came in with, I think, a garbage bag full of little toys and stuff.
He was playing Santa Claus.
But no, we really didn't. And even as I think back, I don't remember us feeling like we were left out,
missing out.
My parents always, you know, we grew up giving Christmas concerts. So it's not like we were anti-Christmas.
Just not like
But we didn't do all the different gifts exchange and stuff like that. So we celebrate the real meaning of it, you know, worshiping God, loving one another, and sharing with others, you know.
So even though your friends were having gifts, you guys didn't ever feel neglected or
No, I mean, when you're in the house with all your family and you guys doing the same thing, you just kind of like, hey, this is what we do.
You guys were pretty content.
Yeah, very content.
I think that's good. I'm glad that we got gifts.
You're glad that your dad brought in the commercial side.
Think it's good. I mean, Christ, if the real meaning of Christmas is Christ, and Christians should at least celebrate him every day, then, you know, it shouldn't be that different.
I don't think there should be this pressure, which I think a lot of people buy into, the stress and pressure of like, we have to have like Christmas and like, meaning presents and gifts. And it's especially
social pressures and
consumerism. And as I've gotten older, I'm more like, let's just have an experience. Like, let's go on a trip. Like, let's just be together.
Yeah,
I don't necessarily care about opening presents. It's fun. I enjoy giving gifts. Of course, I mean, I don't mind receiving them either. But I think that as I get older, I'm more like, I just want to chill with my family and eat and watch Christmas movies. Yeah. And
I think we were talking about that earlier, how as we get older, at least us three, we really don't care as much about the gifts. I don't know, actually.
Wait, you said us three as in me?
Dad does like gifts. He always asks, did you get a lot for me or what?
I think last year, because I was going to have Wyatt around Christmas, we were like, let's just not even do gifts. And Dad was like, no,
I want my gifts.
So he's keeping that part of his life.
I was just having fun with it.
He's looking to me. What else do I have?
Well, I did bring that to this family to give it part.
Because people always ask, like, what do you guys do on Christmas? So we've never done like a big Christmas dinner. That was always Thanksgiving.
No. Our tradition is pretty simple. We come together first thing in the morning, give God praise. We sit for the most part in the
why are y'all laughing at me?
It just sounded very scripted. We come together, we give God praise.
Oh God.
Dad normally reads the scripture. And then I knew this was gonna happen. And then we go around to each other. And what are we grateful for? We do breakfast before or after gifts. Huh?
Come
on, guys.
Here we go again.
Is the breakfast before the gifts or after gifts?
Why is that important? We do breakfast. Okay. But one of the main things we do is we go around and we ask, we really share with one another what we're grateful for. So I'm gonna start with you while they get themselves together.
What am I grateful for?
What are you grateful for this Christmas?
First of all, I'm just grateful, as we all talked about Jesus. I'm grateful to be saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
I'm grateful that I know Him personally.
Yeah.
And also grateful that the world is around us and the people who we are associated with are finding out more about Jesus through our lives, you know, because you know, God has called us to be ministers, and ministers is just bringing the good news to people.
Mm-hmm.
And so Christmas is a time for us to, even now, we're going to have a Christmas Eve service, which we normally don't do at our church. And so it's another way for us to share Christmas with those who may not understand the meaning, because the world is shifting further and further from Christ.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What are they saying? Happy holiday. You know, you hear, that's all you hear now, happy holiday.
Yeah.
Instead of Merry Christmas. And so we have to make sure that we keep saying Merry Christmas.
Yeah.
You know,
keep the Christ. Yeah.
And share the good news.
Mm-hmm. Good. Yeah. All right, Ashley, you're together now. What are you most grateful for?
I am most grateful for a relationship with Jesus, that I know Him personally, that I've received the gift of salvation.
Yeah.
Always eternally grateful for that. That's definitely at the top. I'm grateful for my family. Obviously, last Christmas, I had my firstborn son, Wyatt.
Yes, yes.
And that was obviously a Christmas I'll never forget. Mm-hmm. And so, yeah, I'm excited and grateful for our family growing. I'm grateful for time off, rest, good food.
Amen.
And, yeah, obviously, you guys.
Awesome. Alvin?
Expected answer, but it's a true answer, and that is Jesus. The knowledge of Him, knowing that He exists and He's real.
Yeah.
Believing in Jesus and what that means for me and my life, and forgiveness of sins and hope for a future in heaven with Him. I mean, there's just so much that comes with Him.
Yeah.
And but aside from Him, obviously family, you all, you three, and Kenny and Wyatt. Our church.
Yeah, church family.
Nashville Life.
Nashville Life.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm grateful for everything you guys said, but I want to focus in on, I'm grateful for the eternal gifts.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, the gifts are great, and I think it's symbolic of what Jesus, the gift of Christ and giving, generosity, all of that is a part of who Jesus is. And so I think giving gifts and receiving gifts is a great way to celebrate Him, but I think I hear Wyatt somewhere around here. He's coming on soon, so stay tuned. But those eternal gifts that come along with Jesus, the peace of God.
Yeah.
Oh my God! To me, that's one of the greatest benefits.
Yeah,
the peace, the joy, the love.
Love, yeah.
Like you said, knowing that God is with you, the presence of God, the hope.
Yeah,
I think that's like the number one thing everybody should know about.
On most Christmas cards, you'll either see peace on it, you'll see hope, you'll see love, you'll see joy.
Yeah. And so we want everybody who's watching to understand that with this season comes hope.
Yes.
No matter where you find yourself, no matter what challenges you're facing, there's hope in Jesus. Whatever you need is in Him. Whatever you need.
Man.
And it's that hope that will never leave you.
Yeah.
That hope that will always be there through every season of your life.
Amen.
You know, we're blessed to have one another and our extended family, like Ashley said, Kenny, her wonderful husband, my wonderful son-in-law. Hi, Kenny. He couldn't be with us today. And then, of course, Wyatt, you know.
Your first grandchild.
Yeah, and I'll come back to him in a minute.
And favorite person on the planet.
Yes, and everybody, doesn't have family.
It was a trap. She fell for it.
Everybody doesn't have family surrounded. And so we just want to remind you that you're not forgotten.
Yeah.
And that God loves you and the hope of Christ is for you and with you, you know.
And this is also a really good opportunity too, I think, during the Christmas season, even though it's something we should be doing all the time, the Christmas season is kind of known for, okay, let's give, let's serve, let's help someone in need.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, even if it's people being more open to going to church, like, I think we should take advantage this Christmas season to share Jesus and to invite people to church and to give and to serve, because I think people are almost expecting it this time of year. So I think you'll find people are like more open to those conversations.
To doing it. That's good.
Even if, we believe this is something we should always do, but people who don't have that relationship with the Lord, I think they are kind of more expecting people
okay,
to
so,
be kind
so
of,
you want to encourage people to go and...
Yes, go to find a local church, yeah. Invite somebody to your church, look for opportunities to serve your community, invite
Amen.
Other people
Amen.
Along with
yeah,
it so that they
good.
Can see Jesus in action, because we are
that's
supposed
good.
To be
Jesus
the hands,
in action. That's good.
Hands and feet of Christ. So I think that, yeah, we should all, especially as believers, take advantage of this season to spread the love, talk about Jesus,
yeah.
get the word out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, last year, we had a very exciting Christmas. Well, Ashley had a real exciting Christmas.
Yes.
Speaking
what a
of
day.
Christmas
laborious
day.
Laborious Christmas.
Man,
yeah.
so. Here in Nashville, that morning was a bomb went off, right?
Mm-hmm. So we were downtown.
Downtown Nashville.
Downtown. It was during, of course, the pandemic. And mm-hmm. so Ashley and Kenny were at the hospital, and we were home just praying, mm-hmm. you know, because we couldn't be there.
Yeah.
Oh, that was so
right.
rough for
yeah.
me.
Yeah.
Not to be there for yeah. my daughter's first child. Mm-hmm. But... her husband was with her, and God was with her.
Right.
Yeah. She went through
yes.
a few things.
And Wyatt was with her.
Wyatt came around 4 in the afternoon.
4 in the afternoon.
But yeah, it was like 24 hours of labor. Water broke on Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
He came that next day.
That next
had to have
day.
A C-section. It was a whole thing, but... thank God. I walked out of that hospital so grateful, like, just for my health.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord, like, that I'm healthy. Obviously, that I'm, like, still here. Because, you know, childbirth can be very traumatic
oh,
for a lot
yeah.
of people. But just in general, I was like, I'm so thankful that I'm not, like, accustomed to just this life in the hospital. Because,
yeah.
like, a lot of people have to deal with that and, you know, being in and out of hospital. So I was especially grateful and thankful for health, and that I had, like, was able to come home
yep,
to,
with a healthy
you know,
baby.
With a healthy baby and come
yes,
home to be
Lord.
With family. And, yeah, it was a roller coaster of a few days. But, yeah,
yeah
it was,
yeah.
you said that became your favorite Christmas. But before Wyatt came.
Before Wyatt.
I just learned this today, actually, that.
I was engaged.
You guys got
on
engaged.
Christmas, 37 yes. years
on
ago.
On Christmas.
Well, it was Christmas Eve.
Well, besides
okay.
Wyatt, that's probably your favorite Christmas.
Yeah,
right?
yeah, it was. It was
she had the honor of.
Whenever people ask me about my Christmas memory, it was always Alvin. And
but
I was like,
I don't know why I didn't know
I've
that.
Never heard
why?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Really?
Why have you guys not shared that?
I don't
with your
know.
Children?
I've shared in so many interviews. I don't know why I never shared it with you guys.
Never
but,
knew that.
But
I
why,
knew I got married
why
in June,
be,
but I never, I guess I never
I
asked.
You had a 6-month engagement?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was.
Yep.
I picked up from the airport. It was
snowing.
In Detroit. I mean, it was snowing
oh
so bad.
God,
we almost
so
had to pull over because so much snow
oh,
was coming.
Oh, wow.
And we sat there in the traffic. It wasn't moving, so I had to ring.
You know,
I had planned on giving that to
you. Didn't get on one knee?
Were you so? No, he did not get on one knee.
Well, I guess because he was in the car.
I'm in the car.
You said it
wait
like,
a minute. So was so, your plan to propose on Christmas Day, but you ended up giving it to
I
her?
I don't know what he planned, but
it was doing.
It was. It ended up being
on Christmas
ended
Day.
Ended up being very beautiful
it was on
with
Christmas.
The white snow.
Yeah.
It was really nice.
And the sparkling
yeah.
ring.
Yeah, the sparkling ring.
The big ring, big diamond.
No, it was not
huge,
that big.
The huge rock.
Hey, but 37 years
right.
later.
And you've got since had an upgrade.
Had a couple of upgrades.
Upgrade, yeah.
Oh, a couple of upgrades.
Yeah.
This is the second ring? Third ring?
The second
okay.
ring, right? I think a second, the second.
Yeah, I was about to say, remember, for before that, it was your original.
Is it real?
Oh, get out of here.
Cubic
yes,
zirconia?
Yes.
CZ. How many CZs is that?
So, yeah. So, Ashley, you were talking about how you came home and Wyatt was healthy and you were healthy. And I think that's a gift that a lot of us kind of look over sometimes.
Yeah.
The gift of just being healthy, you
mm-hmm.
know?
Yeah.
Waking up, knowing your name, being able to take care of yourself, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Let's really start focusing in on those things that God has already done. I mean, we experience miracles all the time. And
right.
if you want to call them Christmas miracles, you can
mm-hmm.
because... God is just faithful, and a lot of times we look for things that we don't have or feel or complain, and we forget that we're so blessed, you know? And so I love that.
Yeah.
I think you and Alvin both know us, and of course, we've tried to instill in you guys to be grateful.
Yeah.
To be grateful for what you have, you know? And not just be grateful, but tell people that you're grateful for them, you know, to tell one another that you love them.
I think this, you know, the pandemic has helped people to do that because I think a lot of us took our health for granted. We took our loved ones for granted. So, you know, knowing so many people who have suffered loss, right, and whose personal health has been attacked. It's made us all be like, man, every day is a blessing. We have to count our blessings. We have to tell the people who we love that we love them, yeah, and that we appreciate, yeah, them and honor them while we can, because you just never know.
You don't know.
Well, you know, you think about it, this year is probably the first year in like 2 years that some families have been haven't been together.
Right,
you know?
Yeah.
Because last year, they were telling people not to travel.
Yeah, don't gather.
Don't gather. And so a lot of families who normally would get together on Christmas
haven't.
And Thanksgiving,
right,
didn't.
Yeah,
so,
didn't. Yeah.
So now you're seeing a lot more people traveling and appreciating the time with each other.
That's sure, true.
Yeah, more
that's
so true. Than before.
That's, yeah, true. So always remember to let people know, let the people in your life know that you love them, mm-hmm, and that they matter. Don't wait just for the holiday season, even though this is a good time to start, right?
It's yes, a good time. It's always start. A good time to start.
Speaking of Christmas, again, our tradition, like I said, we get
God
around
praise.
And we give God praise and we talk about how we're what we're grateful for, but then we have food. We have a good breakfast.
Huge breakfast.
Yes. What is
my favorite meal of the day?
What's your favorite? Yeah. So we normally have like cheese grits.
We usually do grits French. And you add cheese in yours.
Oh, yeah. Y'all don't like cheese.
I like cheese.
But I love what Alvin makes.
French toast.
Well, he's been
French
making
toast.
The last few
some
years.
French toast or
with like brioche.
And then bacon, of course, or
yes.
sausage.
Extra yeah. crispy bacon.
Dad makes eggs.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it's pretty good.
Yeah, just yeah. all the good stuff to make
the
you
want
to take a nap after.
Yeah. And then we used to always go see a movie.
A Christmas.
Yeah. Christmas.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
go to the movies. But yeah.
Everybody kind of goes on their own after that.
Yeah, we don't yeah. really
but,
do
but y'all love, y'all to this day, y'all still love watching what?
Which one?
Home Alone. I can't believe you said which one.
Well, there's a lot of Christmas movies that I like. Yeah, Home Alone's great.
National I think it's your
that's
favorite. What's yours?
Christmas.
No, what's yours that Christmas. You like every
oh,
year?
Oh, It's a Wonderful
Life. It's
a Wonderful Life. I finally watched that movie all the way through.
That's a
I think
long
2 years
movie.
Ago, maybe. Yeah.
Long
it's
movie,
it's a
good
movie.
But
now
our dilemma is sharing Christmas Day with Wyatt's birthday. So
yeah.
I think because he was born in the afternoon, it's going to be like, okay, morning, Christmas morning, and
yeah.
then afternoon, it's
then
gonna be
birthday.
Like, happy birthday, Wyatt. It's gonna be a party every
yeah,
year now.
Whatever
on
Wyatt
Christmas.
Wants, yeah, it's gonna work.
Whatever Wyatt wants.
Whatever Wyatt wants.
It's gonna work. So anyway, I'm gonna ask you guys a few questions. What's your favorite Christmas song, Christmas
Ooh,
movie?
Tough one.
And let's just say
gift.
Your favorite gift. So
Gordon,
let me see,
memory.
Who's gonna
Alvin,
go?
You go first.
Song?
Sure.
That's easy. Have Yourself.
Have Yourself?
That's what I was going to say. That's funny.
Little Christmas.
Really? Okay. Have
top,
Yourself.
Top one for me.
Christmas. All right. Song.
I love to hear you sing Oh Holy Night.
Oh,
I love her
you.
Version of Oh Holy Night. Nobody
her
else.
Version.
Oh Holy Night. Okay.
Oh,
okay.
Oh,
let me
Holy
see.
Night.
Mine's. Mine is Christmas List. Grown Up Christmas.
My Grown Up Christmas.
That's yeah, it's a good one.
Natalie Cole.
Good one.
I already said Have Yourself.
I know.
Yeah, you gotta get another one.
I like Oh Christmas Tree.
What?
Oh.
Oh, okay.
Or is it Oh Tannenbaum?
Yeah,
I
you like
that? I do like that song.
It's not a song. I just was not expecting you to say that.
All right, all right.
Well,
favorite,
you took my original
favorite
answer,
Christmas
but...
movie, even though we kind of lit it out the bag.
Yeah, Home Alone.
Which one? One or two?
Let's go with two.
You Home Alone two? 2, Lost in New York.
Yeah.
I'll say Christmas Vacation.
Oh, God.
Well, I'm old-fashioned. It's a Wonderful Life.
It's a Wonderful Life. Let me see. For me, Christmas movie. I don't know.
You don't watch?
A Diva's Christmas Carol.
Yeah, you don't watch.
A Diva's Christmas Carol.
A Diva's what?
Just kidding.
Oh, God.
I'm sure I have. She was a performer.
Right.
I'm sure I have one, but I
Preacher's
don't.
Preacher's wife?
Preacher's wife.
Yeah, do no. you? I don't think she
don't
really
think
likes
she
Christmas.
I don't think I have one. Okay. Okay, Christmas memory.
Oh, okay. When we went to Hawaii, our first
I was
Christmas
say
in
that.
Hawaii.
I didn't
oh,
say that,
man.
We went to Maui.
Right.
I was going to say that.
Now,
too.
I can't remember.
We were so worried about if they were going to miss the snow. And they were like, let's go to the beach.
Is that what happened? Went down there and got all those toys and charged them to our room. All the kids on the beach had all these
floating devices.
Charged right. to the room.
It's a Christmas holiday.
Was that a surprise to us? Was it like surprise or did we know about
no,
it?
That's a long trip to be surprised.
We did too, and they were both great, but of course the first one.
Didn't we do Disney once? Disney World?
Not during Christmas.
I don't know. I feel like maybe we did.
We had
a few warm Christmases.
We did a Disney Christmas.
So that's yours?
The first Hawaii Christmas in Hawaii, which was my first time to Hawaii. And of course, I love Hawaii.
Okay. Yeah. What about
thanks
you?
Thanks to that trip.
Christmas memory.
Your favorite Christmas gift.
Man, I don't know.
We'll give you a minute. You have one?
Try to remember.
No, you got to help me. We went to Hamilton. It was
that New York.
New York.
Oh, yeah. It was New York.
I'm surprised because I've been trying to go to New York and you were always the one against it. So are you going to list this one? You liked it?
Yeah, that was a great one.
Every year I always request to go to New York and Dad was always the one that shut it down.
If
that ended up being your favorite, then that's, well, that makes
well,
me.
This is one that I remember.
Yeah.
Very memorable.
Hamilton.
Christmas time.
Surprise. That was a surprise for me.
Yeah. You were surprised by it.
Yes.
So, Christmas memory, that's it?
Yeah.
I like what's all yours?
Okay, well, I told you mine. Mine
was you're engaged.
Being engaged. Oh. And, of course, Wyatt. Wyatt was just the best.
Last Christmas
was good.
Good? Okay, what else? What about gift? Ashley, favorite gift?
I can't remember the specific gift, but I remember one Christmas y'all really went all out. Uh-huh. And y'all, like, we went down in the basement and you were like, door number one or door number two?
And you remember they
wrapped the doors with wrapping paper?
Wow.
Really?
But I don't remember if y'all really only gave us the gift that, because obviously y'all had bought whatever, so it's already
God,
there.
I forgot all about that.
I guess we got all the doors. But I remember
y'all made it
almost like a game show. It was like, okay, this door or door number two? And I remember being like so excited. I was like, this is great, because it was just something different. So that sticks out to me. But of course, I can't remember the actual gift.
It was the game, the Christmas game.
It was
game.
The presentation. It was
the presentation.
You have a favorite gift, Bae?
Ooh, outside of Wyatt, really?
Wyatt's just kind of made everything else a blur.
Everything else is a blur.
Came on Christmas Day.
All you Christmas babies out there, happy birthday and Merry Christmas. How are we going to do this?
We're going to figure it out. We might have to do half birthdays.
Half birthdays.
But, we'll all be together. That's all that matters. We'll be together and we'll celebrate Christmas and celebrate Wyatt.
Has there been a Christmas that we all four weren't together? I think we've always been together.
I don't think so.
No one's been out of town.
I know when I was living in Hawaii, y'all came.
That's right. When you was in Melbourne, did we miss a Christmas?
It was like, I thought it was January.
Yeah, I came home for Thanksgiving, but y'all came to
so we never missed
Christmas.
We never missed a
were
Christmas
we there
together.
For Christmas?
I think so.
I don't think we've ever missed a Christmas with all the four
I really
of us.
Think so.
Hey, we're together now.
Yeah, I'm thankful that, all my Christmas memories were with you guys.
We're together.
Yeah. Whether we were at home, which most of them were at home, but we've had some destination Christmases, but we always got to be together, which is a blessing.
Thank the Lord.
We're blessed, truly blessed.
Yeah.
Okay, well, cool. I tell you what, we're going to
Are you
going
to sing A Holy Night for Dad?
Full out the whole song.
Okay, back in 2018 and 2019, Alvin produced the Christmas project for you.
Yeah, Something's Happening.
Something's Happening.
Yeah,
and,
good album.
And Tyler Russell.
Great record.
Tyler
you guys
Russell,
should get it.
Yeah, he did a whole play around that project.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And we had two shows at Christ Church.
Yeah.
And then we had two shows at Belmont.
Yeah, and the name of it was It's Christmas, right?
That's right.
It's Christmas.
So,
it's
that was a great... Well, we did a couple of years in a row.
Yeah.
So great memories. All the kids
successful.
Coming together. And,
right.
Yeah, it was awesome. And like you said, the record, Alvin, you had fun doing that record. Was that your first Christmas record to produce?
Yeah, it was.
Great project.
Because I remember coming to the studio and you had the orchestra there.
I know, he had the charts on. I got the charts on.
Was that intimidating for you at all? Or were you just kind of like, I'm ready, let's do this?
It was a little bit. I mean, it was just right after doing Let Them Fall in Love, which was an orchestra. So it wasn't my first. So I think that warmed me up. But this was in a foreign country and no one spoke English. So that was intimidating.
Yeah.
Yeah. But music is the universal language because they had the charts.
That's true.
They had the notes and they were able to play what we wrote. And it was good. Yeah.
Very good Christmas record.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Your songs, we had a few originals on there. How many did you write?
It was like half and half. So I wrote half of them and then the other ones were standards.
Okay. So, so if you're looking for a Christmas record or you want to give a gift.
Feliz Navidad is one of my favorites.
Oh, yeah. Great arrangements. Yeah. I guarantee you're going to enjoy it. Pretty awesome. So, all right. Well, when we come back, we're going to have Wyatt with us.
Our special guest.
The birthday boy. Welcome back. You know, one of our favorite things about Christmas that we all, Ashley gave us Wyatt on Christmas Day.
Wyatt, it's your birthday.
Today is Wyatt's birthday. We are celebrating. Everybody, let's sing.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
He's not smiling.
He is.
Happy birthday, dear Wyatt. Happy birthday to you.
Look, it's your birthday, Wyatt. We've got some
cupcake for you.
You want to taste some? Oh, jeez.
Oh, gosh, here goes. Here goes nothing.
Some sprinkles.
Here goes.
He's very happy now.
Oh, he's neat about it.
Yay.
Sprinkle.
What do you think?
I like that.
You like that sugar?
He said, yeah.
He's being pretty conservative.
He could have stayed here for the whole show and we would have taped it.
Yeah.
Wow.
The sprinkles. Happy birthday, Wyatt.
He got it on his hands.
A whole year old.
Yes, a whole year. I can't believe it. I mean, you know, it just makes Christmas extra special to know that God blessed us with this little one. And we're so glad that you took out the time to join us. And we just pray that this would be your best year for you and your family. Amen. Have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We love you.
Merry Christmas.
Bye-bye.
Happy birthday, Wyatt.
Happy birthday, Wyatt. Happy birthday, Jesus.
Happy birthday, Wyatt.
Happy birthday, Jesus. Oh, come let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Christ the Lord, for he alone is worthy, for he is worthy, for he alone is worthy.